Bernhard Riemann was a genius mathematician who proposed what came to be known as the Riemann hypothesis. The hypothesis is based on an observation he made about his own equation, the Riemann zeta function, stating that every value of the equation that makes it go to zero seems to lie on the exact same line.
Riemann was born on September 17, 1826 in Breslenz, Hanover, now known as Germany. Riemann's father acted as a teacher to him, his two brothers, and four sisters until he was 10 years old. Riemann then lived with his grandmother until her death, at which time he switched to the Johannian Gymnasium. There he worked hard at the classical subjects such as Hebrew and theology, but showed a particular interest in mathematics. The director of the Johannium allowed Riemann to expand his knowledge by studying mathematical texts from his own library. At one point in time, he lent Riemann Legendre's book on the theory of numbers. In 6 days, Riemann had read the complete 900-page book from start to finish. During the spring of 1846, Riemann enrolled at the University of Göttingen, where his father encouraged him to study theology. While studying theology, he attended mathematical lectures, which led him to ask his father's permission to transfer to a different faculty. After he was granted the permission, he transferred into the faculty of philosophy so he could study math from Moritz Stern and Johann Gauss. There is no evidence that at that time Gauss recognized Riemann's genius, but on the other hand, Stern definitely realized that he was a remarkable student. Following his passion, Riemann moved from Göttingen to Berlin University during the spring of 1847 to study under many mathematicians, with Dirichlet as his main influence. Klein, another mathematician, writes,
Riemann was bound to Dirichlet by the strong inner sympathy of a like mode of thought. Dirichlet loved to make things clear to himself in an intuitive substrate. Along with this, he would give an acute, logical analysis of foundational questions and would avoid long computations as much as possible. His manner suited Riemann, who adopted it and worked according to Dirichlet's methods.
Riemann returned to Göttingen in 1849. Working under the supervision of Gauss, he presented his doctoral thesis in 1851. This was a golden year for the budding mathematician as he published his first paper, a celebrated dissertation on the general theory of functions of a complex variable. Though Gauss rarely showed excitement over achievements, in an official report to the faculty, he praised Riemann's work.
The dissertation submitted by Herr Riemann offers convincing evidence of the author's thorough and penetrating investigations in those parts of the subject treated in the dissertation, of a creative, active, truly mathematical mind, and of a gloriously fertile originality.
Years later, Riemann presented the paper on the number of prime numbers less than a given quantity to the Berlin Academy of Science. This paper was the catalyst that began his work with the Riemann zeta function, ultimately culminating as the Riemann hypothesis.
Prime numbers are everywhere, and widely accepted to be the foundation of both pure and applied mathematics. Before being able to understand Riemann, we must first understand the foundation of both his hypothesis and the zeta function.
Primes are the basic building blocks of mathematics. And as far as we know, they occur at random intervals along the number line. Because of that, it's incredibly hard to take a giant number apart and break it down to its prime components. Okay, and that's basically how internet security works. A large unknown prime number hidden inside a giant number that can't be broken down.
Riemann believed he had found a way to locate these prime numbers, notably the very large primes. This equation is essential to proving the Riemann hypothesis. This is the zeta function.
Euler had already considered this function, but Riemann saw it in a different light. Instead of considering the zeta function as a real function, he saw it as a complex one. Hypothesis itself is a single remark that states that all non-trivial zeros have a real part plus 1/2. Now, this probably makes no sense to anybody but a seasoned and educated mathematician. However, the important part here is not all of the technical language. What's important about this is what this brilliant mathematician realized. What Riemann observed is that the frequency of these prime numbers among the natural numbers were all very closely related to the zeta function. All of the interesting solutions to this equation
lie on a vertical straight line. This claim has been verified for 1.5 billion solutions. A proof that is true for every interesting solution would be the key to unlocking many mysteries about prime numbers and their distribution.
The Riemann hypothesis has yet to be resolved and is one of the Clay Mathematics Institute Millennium Problems. Solving it will grant the winner a sum of around $1 million. But even without a solution, Riemann's work has completely altered the direction of research in the field of number theory.
By connecting geometry and space to complex functions, his work has been the foundation for scientists and mathematicians to evolve their knowledge in many areas. These include such subjects as code breaking and the physics of the atomic nucleus.
Riemann died before being able to prove his claims, leaving the problem open for generations of mathematicians to come. The Riemann hypothesis, when solved, will become one of the greatest keys to unlocking the mysteries of mathematics.
Recording, and then we can just cut it.
We can just throw it, okay. The hypothesis itself.
I'm getting dripped on. Sorry, that's my fault. Okay. Nope. Stand right there.
Okay. The hypothesis itself is a single remark stating that all interesting solutions or non-trivial zeros are. It's okay.
Sorry.
The hypothesis itself is a single remark stating that all interesting solutions or non-trivial zeros.
Camera.
This is why I'm never going to be a news reporter or an actress.
No, this is why you're behind the camera, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Recording.
Okay. The hypothesis itself is a single remark.
Stay over there.
Oh, my hair is doing stupid things.
Ready?
I thought I would try and take it, but it wouldn't hit.
When they're done trying to hit the hypothesis itself is a single remark stating that all